Thank you very much. Very good morning. I think I have to start with my opening remarks, but we are a little bit behind schedule, so rather than trying to dispense wisdom to you, I thought we will economize on time. We have had a very substantive opening remarks and a keynote speech, and also we have an eminent panel to give you enough substance. So I'll leave these prepared remarks aside and try to go straight. Just to make a couple of points only, that first of all, I want to commend the Army and the organizers for choosing this topic, which is both timely and of immense policy and practitioner relevance here. Of course, the notion of disruption at first glance gives you a negative connotation. I would say that it is not so always. Disruption can be both innovative as well as destructive. Depends on the way the initiator of disruption wants it to behave. There are plenty of examples. I'm sure some of our panelists will touch on them. They range from the globalization to Galileo to many aspects, and currently also there are a lot of disruptions, trade wars, attacks on multilateralism. Some may see these as grave disruptions to the world order. Globalization disrupted the neat state sovereignty system, and there is a talk of deglobalization now, whether this will further disrupt. If so, whether it will disrupt innovatively or destructively, jury is still out there. But what is clear is what we are going to discuss in our panel. It's a very clear and present disruption, and that it requires also, as we will see, it requires also immense international cooperation. Not necessarily international competition or power balancing strategic arrangements, but pure and simple international cooperation, because many of these demographic shifts and related migration matters are issues that one nation alone cannot handle. Stating the obvious, but sometimes we ignore the obvious and think that in an exclusive fashion, by building walls, by erecting barriers, we can handle these things, because we are faced with terrible contradictions. Now, in a progressing world, we try to open borders for goods and services, but close them for people, especially those in distress. That's not a tenable or sustainable contradiction anymore. Looking at the magnitudes, stark figures of 70 million, nearly 65.8 million refugees worldwide, and most of them, not most, many of them women and children, and to this inventory one must add the latest UN figures, the migrant smuggling industry. Migrant smuggling is a $5 billion industry in which there were 2.5 million victims in 2016 alone. And whether it is in the Mediterranean or in Europe or latest in Venezuela, refugee populations and demographic and migratory shifts are blooming, wrong word, not blooming, but increasing. And unfortunately, with this growth, anti-migrant sentiments are also growing, which is sadly evident in some of the hitherto migrant-friendly countries. In fact, the most powerful country in the world is a product of migration, but unfortunately, it seems that walls are coming up against that. These probably are the solutions, one does not know, but certainly seems to be a unique solution. So all these are issues I'm sure will be addressed. So without taking up more time, I think we have we will start with our panel presentations. Each panelist will have 20 minutes, I'm told. And the first speaker is Dr. Caroline Halliday, who is a senior lecturer in the National Security Affairs Department of the Naval Postgraduate School in Monterey. She is a historian and a lawyer. Although focusing on Europe, she has participated in Center for Civil Military Relations program around the world. She is a lecturer at the Penn State and also teaches at the George Washington University in Washington, D.C. And her service in the government has included working as a historian in the State Department and a prosecutor in the Department of Justice of the United States, and a degree holder from prestigious schools like the University of California and Stanford and so forth. So may I please ask Dr. Halliday now to take the floor?